Hey friends, Johnny May here, and welcome to this quick tip where I'm gonna teach you 11 of the most important chord progressions that you should learn. These chord progressions are used in hundreds of your favorite songs, and so if you learn these progressions, you're gonna be able to learn your favorite tunes much faster. All right, progression number one is what I call the power progression, and it sounds like this. A very similar version of this progression is used in the Coldplay tune Clocks. And it's a very simple progression because it only uses four chords. The first chord is called a C add 2. It is a beautiful chord like a C major, except we're adding a note to it. The next chord is awesome. It's called a G minor 11, and it actually uses these six notes here, okay? It's called a G minor 11. It's actually not very hard to play. Third chord is called a B flat add 2. It's like a B flat major chord, and we're adding the second note to it. And then finally, an F add 2. It's like an F major, and we're just adding a G to it. Now, the way to think of this chord progression is a 1, 5, flat 7, 4 chord progression. And here's what I mean. When you're thinking about chords, it's best to think of them as numbers related back to the major scale. And so if you're in the key of C major, you'd call this a 1 chord. And then on the G, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you'd call this a 5 chord. Does that make sense? And then on the 7th, instead of a B, you'd use a B flat. So you'd say flat 7, and then you go to your 4 chord, and so this is an F chord. Now, one thing to keep in mind is your chord quality, meaning on the 1 chord it's major, but on the 5 chord it's minor, right? And then on the 7 chord it's major, and then on the 4 chord it's also major. So here's a great way that you can get started playing this chord progression. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm taking each chord, like C, I'm rolling down the chord, and then I'm breaking it up. And then same thing for the next chord. Gorgeous G minor 11 chord. I'm taking all those notes earlier, and I'm just clustering them together. And I'm breaking up the notes of the chord, right? And then B flat, same technique. Rolling down my B flat, add 2, breaking up the notes, right? And then on the F chord, right, same thing. I'm just rolling down an F add 2 and then breaking up the chord like that. All right, before I teach you progression number 2, if you're enjoying the video, please hit the like button. And if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe for more videos just like this. All right, progression number 2 is what I call the John Williams progression, and it sounds like this. This chord progression is used in Princess Leia's theme in Star Wars, which was composed by John Williams. Now, this chord progression is amazing because it only uses two chords. The first chord is a simple C major, but the second chord is the magical chord. On this chord, you're gonna play this beautiful F minor 9. So it's an F minor 6, right? F minor triad, you got the 6 there, and then the 9, which makes it beautiful. Now, this chord progression is what's called a 1-4 chord progression because we're starting on the 1 chord, C, and then we're going up to the 4 chord, 1, 2, 3, 4, F, and we're making it minor. So here's a really beautiful way that you can get started playing this progression. Oh, so beautiful. So I'm just basically taking my chord, C add 2, I'm breaking up the notes in my right hand, you see that? And then my F minor 6, 9, that is the chord right there. And I'm just breaking it up and I'm ending on my C, okay? And then you do the same thing. And then I like to change it here. I go way up to the high E, and then I play this chord, same chord. It's an F minor 6-9, but I'm delaying the D and then coming down to the D there. All right, progression number three is what I call the gospel progression, and it goes like this. This chord progression is used on tunes like Chameleon by Herbie Hancock. This is a very groovy chord progression used in lots of gospel and funk music. And I love this progression because it only uses two chords. The first chord is a simple C7 chord, and then the second chord is a simple F7 chord. Very simple. Now, this is another 1-4 chord progression because we're starting on a 1 chord in the key of C, and then we're going to a 4 chord F. Now, keep in mind the quality of these chords. This is a 1-4 chord progression, but unlike the previous 1-4 chord progression, these chords are going to be dominant chords, or called dominant 7th chords. So this is a 1, dominant 7 chord, and then a 4, dominant 7 chord. Now, if you want to get started playing this chord progression, a great way to play this is like this. Okay, basically what I'm doing is I'm playing my C7 chord like this, and I'm sliding the E, so, and then I'm doing a little passing chord, it's like an F major, and back down to my C7, and then a little walk up, see that? And then F7 with a little slide there on the A, passing chord B-flat, and back down to my F7, and then my little bass line, right back to my C. By the way, I wanted to mention that you can download and print the lesson sheet music. You can also change the key of the entire lesson with the click of one button with our smart sheet music. So I'll put a link to all of that below. All right, progression number four is what I call the pop chord progression, and it goes like this. This progression is used on tunes like Despacito. And this chord progression is actually incredibly simple. Basically, you're starting on an A minor, then you're going to an F major, and then a C major, and then finally a G major. This is a 6-4-1-5 chord progression, and that's because in the key of C, the A is the 6th note of the scale. So we have a 6, then a 4, then a 1, and then a 5 chord. So a great way to get started playing this chord progression is like this. Basically, I'm just breaking up the chord. You see that? And then on the F, very simple, and then on the C, and then finally on the G, I come up, and then you can repeat it. By the way, if you want to learn more about this chord progression, including how you can accompany on it, check out our course, Pop and Contemporary Piano Accompaniment Patterns. I'll put a link to it below. All right, progression number five is what I call the turnaround chord progression, and it goes like this. This is used on classic jazz tunes like I Got You Under My Skin. And the chords, once again, are very simple. The first chord is what's called a D minor 7. The next chord is a G13. It's actually a G7 chord, but you're gonna add two notes, A and E. And in just a minute, I'll show you how to put these notes together to make it sound really nice. Next chord is a C major 7. And then your last chord is a really cool chord called an A7 with a flat 9. Okay, it's a very jazzy chord. This is called a 2-5-1-6 chord progression, and that's because we're in the key of C, and we're starting on a 2 chord, then we're going to a 5 chord, and then a 1 chord, and finally a 6th chord, and this is based on the C major scale. And once again, when we use these numbers like 2, 5, 1, and 6, we're basing them on the notes of the major scale, right? C major scale. So here's a great way to get started playing this chord progression. Okay, basically I'm starting on that D minor 7 chord, but I'm using this chord voicing. It's basically the way I play the notes of the chord, and then I go to my G chord. Oh, beautiful. This is that G13, and I'm sliding the E there. See that? And then to my C chord, okay, playing it like this, and then on the A chord, we're gonna play it like this. Okay, it's an A7 with a flat 9. And then you just repeat it. I like to come down here at the very end on the C chord, and then my A chord, I like to play it here. By the way, if you want to learn even more about the turnaround chord progression, we put together a full-length course on this progression called The Amazing Turnaround. I'll put a link to it below. All right, progression number 6 is what I call the love progression, and it sounds like this. This progression is used on tons of popular love songs, and it's also used on the Billy Joel tune, Piano Man. Now, what makes this chord progression beautiful is it has this walk down in the left hand bass line, okay? So first chord is a simple C major, second chord is a beautiful chord called a G add 2 over B, okay? Next chord, simple A minor. Next chord, I love, okay? It's a C major 7 with a G in the bass. Then we go to an F with an add 2. Then a C add 2 over E, really beautiful. And then a D minor 7, that's our 2 chord. And then finally at the end, I like to play these really cool chords. This is called a G9 with a sus4, and then it resolves to a G9. So you can think of this chord progression as a 1-7-6-5-4-3-2-5 chord progression, but it's important to remember that you're using inversions of chords. So this is a 1 chord, this is actually a 5 over a 7, okay? 6 chord, then this is a 1 over a 5. Does that make sense? So you can think of it as 1-7-6-5-4, but remember they're inversions. Now a great way to get started playing this chord progression is like this. Oh, beautiful. I'm just starting on a C major, and then I'm using my G add 2 over B like that. Really beautiful. Then A minor, and then I love this one. Oh, isn't that gorgeous? That's the C major 7 over G. And then there's my F add 2. Lovely C add 2 over E. And then there's my D minor 7. And finally, okay, G9 sus4, and then I resolve it like that. By the way, if you want to learn how to improvise over the love progression, we have a great course on this called our Love Progression Challenge, so I'll put a link to that below. All right, progression number 7 is what I call the Happy Monday progression, and it sounds like this. And this progression is used on tons of pop tunes, including Ed Sheeran's Thinking Out Loud. All right, this chord progression is very simple because it only uses 4 chords. The first chord is a simple C major, then the magical chord, this is that C add 2 over E, then a beautiful F with an add 2, and finally a really cool chord you can play on the G is this. It's actually like a D minor over a G in the bass. And you can think of this chord progression as a 1-3, you see that on the bass? And then 4-2-5. All right, and a great way that you can get started playing this chord progression is like this. Okay, really groovy, starting with the C on the bottom, sliding up to the E and the G. You see that? And then down slide to the D. See that? And then we come up to the F. It's gonna do a slide again. See that? So sliding up to the A, coming down, and then I love this part. Okay, it's basically a D minor chord over G, but I'm sliding up to the D. See that? So, and then I land on my C again, and we start the chord progression over. By the way, if you want to learn how to improvise over this chord progression, we put together a full-length course on this called Pop Piano Improv Happy Monday. I'll put a link to it below. All right, progression number 8 is what I call the sentimental progression, and it goes like this. And this progression is used on lots of popular tunes, including My Funny Valentine. This progression is also very unique because it has this little walk down in the left-hand bass line. So the first chord is a simple C minor. Next chord is a G7, but you're gonna play this over a B, okay? Next chord is a C minor over B flat, and then your final chord is a beautiful chord called an A half diminished, or A minor 7 flat 5. So you could think of this chord progression as a 1-7 flat 7-6 chord progression. And once again, these are inversions of chords. So you're not actually playing like a B chord, you're actually playing a G7 over B, right? And then same with the B flat, you're not playing like a B flat major, you're playing a C minor over B flat. So these are inversions, but once again, you can think of it as a 1-7 flat 7-6 chord progression. And a great way that you can get started playing this chord progression is like this. Basically, I'm breaking these chords up, C minor, then my G7 over B, see that? And then C minor over B flat, and finally my A minor 7 flat 5, and I just play the chord like that. By the way, if you want to learn more accompaniment techniques and how to improvise over the sentimental chord progression, we have a full-length course on this progression, and I've linked to it below. All right, progression number 9 is what I call the doo-wop progression, and it goes like this. This progression is used on lots of popular tunes, including Justin Timberlake's Can't Stop the Feeling. And the reason I call this the doo-wop chord progression is because it's used in a lot of 1950s doo-wop style music. This chord progression only really uses 3 chords. We're gonna start on a C chord, and we're gonna add the 2 in there for a little color. Then we're gonna go to a 6 chord, an A, but we're gonna make this a minor 7 chord, so we're just gonna add a little G to it to make it interesting. Then we're gonna go to a 4 chord, it's an F chord, and we're gonna play it up here, and I'm gonna add some really colorful notes to it. Okay, so this is called an F major 9, and then we're gonna go back to our C add 2 chord, okay? So this is a 1-6-4-1 chord progression in the key of C. Now you can get started playing this chord progression with a pretty fun groove. It goes like this. Basically what I'm doing is I'm taking each chord and I'm doing these little punches on them, okay? So it's like ta, 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 okay? And then I hit the C and do a little lead-in line. See that? And then I'm into my A minor chord, okay? And I do the same punches, ta, ta, ta. And then I do the same little lead-in line. And then I love this chord. Okay, this is that F major 9 that I told you about earlier, and I'm just punching the chord. See that? And then the same little lead-in line. and then I end it on my C chord. Okay, and it's the same thing. I grab the chord, punch it, one more chord, and I end like that. All right, progression number 10 is what I call the cycle of fifths chord progression, and it goes like this. This is used in lots of popular jazz tunes like Fly Me to the Moon. So the first chord is an A minor 7 chord. This is a 6 chord in the key of C, okay? Then we go to a 2 chord D minor 7, then a 5 chord G 7. Then a 1 chord, C major 7, okay? A few more chords. F major 7 is our next chord. Then a B minor 7, flat 5. And finally an E 7 chord. This one has a G sharp in it, okay? And then finally an A minor 7 chord. So you can think of this chord progression as being in the key of C. So we're starting on a 6 chord, and then 2, 5, 1, 4, 7, 3, back to 6. And a great way that you can get started playing this chord progression is with these really nice little chord shells. Okay, I'm basically taking my first chord, A minor 7, I'm playing it like this, and then I do a little bass line down to the fifth, and then my D minor 7, right, there it is, and then I do the bass line, right, up to G. These are simple chord shells that use the third and seventh of each chord, okay? So, bass line, and then my C major 7, really nice, bass line, okay? F major 7, same thing, bass line, okay? B minor 7, flat 5, there it is, bass line, and then E 7, bass line, and then finally end on my A minor 7. By the way, if you want to learn more about the cycle of fifths chord progression, including different accompaniment techniques and how to improvise over it, we have the full-length course, which I have linked to as well below. All right, the final chord progression, number 11, is last but not least, and it's arguably one of the most important ones you should learn. This is your blues chord progression. So here's how it sounds. Chord progression is used on lots of different tunes. In fact, it's used on an Elvis tune called Hound Dog. It goes like this. So this chord progression really just uses three chords. You have a C7, then you have an F7 chord, but we're gonna add a note to this. We're gonna add the G, which makes it an F9. And then your third chord is what's called a G7 chord. So you could call the C chord a 1 chord, the F is a 4 chord, and the G is a 5 chord. And when you play a blues, you typically play them in 12 bars, or a 12 bar blues. And the chords will go like this. 1, 4, 1, 1. 4, 4, 1, 1, 5, 4, 1, 5. So here's how you can get started playing a very simple blues chord progression. Okay, basically I'm taking my chords, C7, I'm playing it like this, F9, I'm gonna play it like this, and then my G7, I'm gonna play it like this. Okay, and then in my left hand, I'm just walking the notes of the chord in my bass line. So I'm going C, and then F. Very simple, okay? And then if you put your chords together, it goes like this. C, pop, okay? Keep going on the chord. And then F, chord, pop. Make sense? And then you're back to C, right? And I'm following my 12-bar blues, okay? Then we go to an F chord. Okay, making sense? You're gonna stay here and then back to C. You're doing a good job, same thing. Okay, and then the 5 chord, that's a G. Okay, and then the F. Makes sense, and then back to C. And finally a G chord at the very end. Makes sense? By the way, if you want to go deeper on the blues and you want to learn how to create awesome improvisations in your right hand, our top course on this is called the 10 Lesson Blues Challenge, and I've linked to that below. Hey, thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed the lesson, please leave a comment. Also, be sure to check out pianowithjohnny.com. We have over 1,000 step-by-step lessons for all playing levels where you'll learn your favorite songs, styles, and how to improvise at the piano. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.